Damn.
Showtime, Sean Porter. Don't be shy. Give him a round of applause. Showtime, Sean Porter. Great to see him. He's decked out. I love his shoes, by the way. Great to see Sean Porter. He's got a date on September 28th against Errol Spence. What a matchup that is going to be. We will further dive into that. Now let's meet a man who is the former undisputed super welterweight champion of the world, the Hall of Famer, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Winky Wright. Put your hands together for Winky Wright. Talk about a technician inside that very ring, Winky Wright.
Y'all better stop playing and clap for Winky.
Yeah, I was going to say, put your hands together. Show this man some love. And speaking of love, Marco Antonio Barrera, ladies and gentlemen, the three-division world champion from Distrito Federal, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, presentando Marco Antonio Barrera.
Barrera.
My brother, nice seeing you.
Un placer, Marco.
Hola,
¿cómo están?
Perdón, que me atraviese.
And also, a four-division world champion, ladies and gentlemen, also from Mexico, always has been in tremendous battles, countless wars. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, aquí está el terrible Eric Morales. Gracias, Eric. And also we have Felix de Jesus, who always does a phenomenal job translating. All right, we're going to start off with, first of all, we'll begin with the man to my immediate right, Sean Porter. Sean, Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman this Saturday. As I look at the odds, Manny Pacquiao is minus 155. Keith Thurman is the underdog. Does that surprise you heading into this matchup?
No. That doesn't surprise me at all. We all know what Manny's done. He is a living legend. You cannot take that away from him. And so I think when the fight was announced, I think everyone saw the young lion coming out and taking over. But I think as people started to really look at this fight as a whole, it started to see that, you know, Manny Pacquiao is Manny Pacquiao, and you can't take that away from him. So I think he's the favorite to win this fight for a reason.
Now, Winky Wright, you know quite a bit about Keith Thurman. You guys are from down there in Florida. I believe you actually sparred with him when he was a young man. What did you take away from your initial impressions from a very young Keith Thurman?
Oh, when I first met Keith Thurman, it was incredible the power this young kid had and the will to win. So I think that Manny Pacquiao is a great fighter. He's going to come out throwing a lot of punches, but I just think Keith Thurman's jab and his movement and his power is harder than Manny think it is.
Now for Marco Antonio Barrera, can you tell us, both you and Morales have been inside the ring against Manny Pacquiao, but what is it like to be standing across the ring and having to deal with the explosiveness of Manny Pacquiao?
Bueno, Manny Pacquiao es un peleador, cuando lo tienes enfrente, arriba del cuadrilátero, muy fuerte, muy rápido. Una energía impresionante que de repente te envuelve en el estilo.
Well, Manny Pacquiao, when you're up there and you're facing him, he's a strong, explosive, fast fighter.
Entonces sí te impacta un poco la forma en como él pelea, pero pues aquí a mi lado está el primero que lo venció ya cuando empezó a ser grande.
Well, yeah, it's very impactful when you see him right there in front of you, but we got Morales here, who was the first man to beat him.
Well, and that's to my next point. Thank you very much, Marco. He's done television a few times as he leads me into my next point. Eric, for you, you fought here against Manny Pacquiao at the MGM Grand. What was the key to success, aside from the fact that you had tremendous heart in that fight? But tell us about defeating Manny Pacquiao and how significant that was for you and what Keith Thurman needs to do.
Bueno, buenas tardes. Prácticamente lo que hicimos es usar boxeo técnico, claramente aspectos técnicos para poder lograr la victoria y siempre buscar su lado más débil. Llegué bien preparado, bien entrenado, así que no hubo problema.
First of all, good afternoon. Basically, to win that fight, I was very technical against Manny Pacquiao. That's what Thurman needs to do. And well prepared, which I was on that night.
Now, Sean, fighting Keith Thurman, you've been inside the ring with them, a very close matchup. But in this fight leading into against Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman has stated he's going to retire Manny Pacquiao. He's been doing a lot of talking. Does that surprise you? Do you think that Keith is out of character, or is this a new Keith Thurman that he wants to once again have the biggest moment of his career?
No, Keith's not out of character at all. One thing that I'm sure Winky knows about Keith is he does not say anything that he doesn't mean. He believes everything that he says. The confidence that you see from coming from him now is very real. And the number one thing that Winky just said is his will to win. He has a will to win. 29 wins, no losses. He figures out a way to do it. And I think going into this fight, he says the way I'm going to beat Manny is by destroying him and making him retire. He believes he can do that within 3 rounds. And I'm not mad at him. I understand from a fighter's perspective, when you figure out what you want to do to beat somebody, that's what you're going to do. There's no one. Even if Winky has been in every camp with him, and Winky said, yo, man, I don't think you... He's going to say, Winky, you ain't with me on this one. You know, 3 rounds is it, you know? So I'm a firm believer that he's going to go out there. He's going to try to put the gas to the metal real quick and try to get Manny out of there.
Winky, could that play and be a detriment for Keith Thurman, or is it more incentive for him to start early? Because he's predicting, as Sean mentioned during the press conference yesterday, he said he's betting on himself in the first couple rounds.
Well, of course, you know, every fighter betting on himself or believing himself. You know, when I fought, I bet on myself because I believe I was going to win no matter what. Like you just said, Keith is a fighter that believes in his ability. He believed that he can go out here and knock Manny Pacquiao out. How he does it is a different thing. Manny is a fighter that, you know, he in and out. His movement is Manny's great thing with him. He in and out, he throw quick punches. You know, he moves a lot. You know, he's tough. But Father Age is undefeated. You know, Father Time will get every fighter. We all great at one time. But when we got older, we lost that step. We lost that 1/10 of a second that took us from being great to normal. And when they take you from being great to normal, that's when things can happen. You know, Manny Pacquiao look good on the mitts and all the bag. The bag and the mitts don't hit back. Fighters will tell you all the time. You see fighters out there, everybody wants to do the Floyd Mayweather mitt drill, not looking and hitting the mitts and not looking over here. You don't fight like that. I don't know how many fighters ever hit the mitt and hit a fighter and be looking over here. So, you know, the mitts and all that don't hit back. Keith Thurman hit back. Manny Pacquiao hits back. So, whatever fighter can put their will on another fighter, that's the fighter that's going to win.
Marco, you fought Manny Pacquiao twice. Eric fought him 3 times. What is the memory that you have from fighting Manny Pacquiao?
Bueno, primeramente, fueron 2 peleas muy fuertes. Sin ningún pretexto, las 2 derrotas que tuve ante él. Es un boxeador que le gusta el intercambio de golpes. Le gusta sentirse presionado, le gusta meter presión. Yo en ciertos momentos de la pelea.
First of all, it was 2 great fights, and no pretext. But why I lost the fight? Because he puts in a lot of pressure. He's always on top of you, Manny Pacquiao.
Yo en ciertos momentos de la pelea sentía que, o pensaba psicológicamente que se estaba alimentando de golpes y es por eso que le ponía muchísimas ganas. Difícil de poderlo aventar hacia atrás. Difícil poder contragolpearlo por la guardia zurda y aparte, por lo que nunca, él en la primera pelea terminó conmigo pegándome al cuerpo.
Psychologically, it's a tough fight to fight Manny Pacquiao at any time because you think that he's going to go back, but he doesn't go back. He maintains a pressure, constant pressure on you.
Also for you, Eric, here the fight is on Saturday night at the MGM Grand, live on pay-per-view, Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman. What does it mean? What goes through your mind when you're making that ring walk and it's sold out here at the MGM Grand? Millions of people watching all over the world on pay-per-view. Can you tell us how you felt when you made that ring walk against Manny Pacquiao over a decade ago?
Bueno, realmente al final del día todos nos ponemos nerviosos un poco, pero una vez estando arriba del ring y empiezas a trabajar y empiezas a hacer tu trabajo, te concentras en lo que realmente tienes que hacer y bueno, vas viendo los cambios que tienes que ir adaptando y poco a poco vas armando tu plan, aplicando tu plan en la pelea.
At the end of the day, we all get nervous when we go into the ring, especially with such a big event. But once you get in the ring and you start fighting, you start adapting to it, and then the plan of attack that you've worked during training. So that's basically what you are about to do when you're up there.
Sean, what did you take away from your matchup, your clash against Keith Thurman? Because that was a heck of a fight. I mean, many people thought it was the fight of the year, but when you walked away from the ring and as you took time to examine the matchup, what did you take away from your fight with Thurman?
You know, not just myself, but a few other fights that I've seen him fight in, his fight with Jose Cito Lopez recently. Keith Thurman knows how to dictate the pace. He knows how to dictate the range. He knows how to close it when he needs to, and he knows how to create it and keep it wide when he needs it wide. He knows how to, move and box. And I think that's going to play into his hands in this fight. You know, Manny's a multi-punch kind of fighter. He likes to punch in combinations. He likes to come forward. Keith likes to draw you in. You know, he that's his rhythm. He knows how to draw you in and counter from there, turn you, things like that. So
he sets traps.
He sets traps. So I think that's going to be a really key component for Keith in this fight, is to be able to set those traps and essentially keep Manny off balance. What we know most guys are used to, or what Manny's used to doing to other guys, is keeping them off balance. Well, now he's in the ring with a guy that can box, can move, and has power behind that, and can keep you off balance. So it's just a really, really interesting fight on both sides.
Well, we know about the speed with Manny Pacquiao. That is obviously a foregone thought. But a way to counteract the speed is with timing. The fact, Winky, that Keith Thurman was away from the ring for over 2 years, fought Jose Cito Lopez in January, do you think that Keith Thurman can have the timing to counter Manny Pacquiao in his speed and his explosiveness?
Yes. He came back and had that fight, and that was the fight that allowed him to get his timing back. It allowed him to get back in the ring and remember what it feels like to get hit. You know, he fought Sean Porter. Sean put a lot of pressure on fighters. So a lot of fighters can't really understand how much pressure this man put on you. And if you're not ready for that, if you're not able to adjust in the ring, if you're not able to, you know, get the distance you need to get your punches off, you're going to lose, because he's going to crowd you. He's going to make it look ugly, but he's going to win. He's going to hit you to the body. He's going to do what he got to do to win. So by seeing the fight with Sean, by seeing the fight with Lopez, you know, keeps showing you his diverse boxing game. And a lot of people don't really understand that. They just think of him as a puncher. But the distance that he allows himself to throw them big shots, Keith can jump this way, hit you with a big right hand, go back this way, hit you with a big left hand, and it hurt. And you can hear the punch, boom, boom, boom. It ain't like no regular shot. Them are some powerful shots. So, you know, if Manny jump in and get caught, like he caught Manny. He caught Manny with a perfect right hand, right on the button, and he went to sleep. So it can happen in this fight, and the same thing can happen to Keith. If he don't pay attention, if he take Manny for granted, Manny can't hurt you. Manny throw a lot of good body shots, a lot of good strong shots, and he can hurt you. But I just think that Keith is on his game right now. If he come out and take Manny, dictate Manny's progress or Manny's ability to jump in and out, Keith will win the fight.
Marco, you were without a doubt one of the most brilliant technicians that a Mexican fighter has ever demonstrated. But can you tell us about how difficult it is to hit and connect clean against Manny Pacquiao because of how unorthodox he is and his head movement?
Bueno, es muy difícil por la forma en cómo se mueve, porque a pase de ser zurdo, entraba, salía de una forma muy diferente. De hecho, brincaba casi medio metro para poderte cruzar de mano derecha, mano izquierda. Entonces me dificultaba la forma de poderlo agarrar, más por el estilo que yo tenía, más parado, ir enfrente, mover la cintura. se me dificultaba su rapidez.
No, it's very difficult. He's a boxer. He's a lefty, first of all, and sometimes he jumps, so he might be a meter away from you. And I'm a fighter that was very technical, so that made it more difficult to even hit Manny Pacquiao.
Eric, you did a brilliant job in against Manny Pacquiao, cutting off the ring, not letting Manny move around the ring with as the ease that he had in other fights. Can you tell us and dive into the fact that Keith Thurman is going to have to cut off the ring and not allow Manny Pacquiao to use every bit of that ring?
Bueno, tienes que estar enfrente de él y buscando los tiempos exactos para caminarle a tu mano izquierda y buscar e iniciar los ataques, no darle oportunidad. Tienes que ir presionarlo, moverlo y llevarlo a los puntos que tú quieres y volver a empezar, caminar a la izquierda, atacar. Es un tema de una estrategia, una línea de trabajo.
No, you definitely have to have a strategy against Manny Pacquiao, and you have to have your timing correct against him because he'll slip out. So you got to work on it, and if he gets out, you got to start again and pressure him, and of course that's the way I beat him.
Sean, for you to be able, when you fought Keith Thurman, you were big, you're big and strong, and you like to impose your will. For Keith now, he's the bigger man coming into this fight against Manny Pacquiao. Do you think that Keith, he is a very technical fighter, but he's going to try to use his physicality in this fight on Saturday night live on pay-per-view?
Yeah, I think for sure. I think, just like we've seen Keith in the media say just about any and everything you can say to Manny, I think he's going to do the same thing in the ring. He's going to do just about any and everything he can do to Manny, like outside the ring to get him uncomfortable, in the ring to get him uncomfortable. I think that that's probably a part of his game plan, is to get Manny uncomfortable, shake him up, and like I said before, he believes in his power.
Winky, do you believe that with Manny Pacquiao, he darts in and out, he throws a ton of combinations, but if Thurman can connect early against Manny Pacquiao, that it'll make Manny a little quote-unquote gun-shy to throw the combinations that he's used to and accustomed to throwing?
That's right. If he can catch Manny, if he can time Manny coming in and out and hit him with some hard shots, that could bring back memories of when Morales knocked him out. And, I've never been knocked out, but a fighter that's been knocked out always got that in the back of his mind that he don't want that to happen again. So keep, like I said, keep throw good punches from both sides, good body shots. Manny is very fast, and, he in and out. But how fast is this Manny versus the last Manny? You know what I'm saying? Like I said, Father Time is undefeated. We all, suffered to Father Time. Roy Jones was the baddest man on the planet one time because of his ability, his natural ability to be so fast. That Roy, that tenth of a second, Roy already had it. But when he became older, that tenth of a second allowed him to become normal now. Now he getting caught with shots that he never would have got caught with. Overhand rights and, uppercuts and stuff like that. So Father Time is undefeated. Can Manny be the Manny we knew back in the days, or is it going to be the Manny that fought Marquez?
Marco, Thurman has proclaimed, and we mentioned that he wants to retire Manny Pacquiao. You've been in the ring with him. Do you think that the talking from Thurman is at all getting into the mind of Manny Pacquiao?
Pues aparte de entrar psicológicamente a Manny Pacquiao, puede tener un poco de puede ser verdad si es que se preparó con muchísimas ganas. Hay que recordar que tiene 10 años menos. Y para un boxeador, el rival, el peor rival que es la edad. Entonces, 30 contra 40 podría ser por ahí que Thurman, metiendo presión, ganándole con esa juventud, con rapidez, pasos laterales, como dice el terrible Morales, llevándolo a las cuerdas de punto a punto para poder así ir minando la condición física, puede ser posible. Pero también puede ser posible que Pacquiao pues lo lleve de la mano y lo lleve a la escuela por la experiencia que tiene.
Yeah, it could be. It's a possibility. I mean, he's 10 years younger. He's 30. Manny Pacquiao's 40. And if he keeps, if he trained well, if he keeps putting the pressure on Manny Pacquiao, man, there's a possibility. And like what Morales said, that, maybe if you take him into the corners and work Manny, there's a shot. Yeah, there's a shot.
Eric, are you surprised Manny Pacquiao, 40 years of age, he will be 41, I believe, in December, if I'm correct. Are you surprised that Manny Pacquiao is fighting still at this elite level in the welterweight division against guys who are at least 10 years his junior?
Bueno, sí, sí, sí estoy sorprendido que siga peleando. Ha tenido grandes, muchos grandes, grandes peleas, grandes guerras, pero a la misma vez no, porque es un peleador que siempre está activo, entrenando en forma, haciendo alguna actividad física para estar muy vigente, y eso le da permiso de realmente estar en óptimas condiciones. Prácticamente es un gran atleta.
Well, I'm definitely surprised, yeah, that he's fighting at this age, and due to the fact that all the wars he's had. So it's very interesting that he's still fighting. But then again, I'm not surprised, because mentally, physically, he's always still training and still maintaining, all out through his career, this great training regimen. So by that, I'm not surprised. But I am surprised by the time and the wars that he's had, that he's still active.
Sean, as we get set for Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman this Saturday live on pay-per-view. Also before that, live on Fox, Caleb Plant and Mike Lee. Sean, do you like the fact, as we see this old school in Manny Pacquiao against the new school in Keith Thurman, how compelling, how exciting is this? Because we're sort of merging generations together on Saturday night at this elite level.
Yeah, I mean, traditionally this happens. It hasn't happened in a very long time in boxing, but, you know, this is a part of the tradition. There's always the young guy that comes and takes over. And by doing so, he takes out the guy who's considered to be the legend, or, you know, the king. And, you know, since Mayweather's made his exit, I think everyone has kind of put Manny Pacquiao in that position. And again, like, he deserves it. But at the same time, I do think that, you know, at the end of it, you know, we all can sit up here and say what we think is going to happen. But the fact that this fight is actually happening is the best part about it. There's so many different ways, so many different variables that add up to this fight going so many different ways. You know, I think that's the best part about this matchup. It's really, really interesting and exciting. And like I said, I can pick Manny, he can pick Keith. But at the end of the day, we all got to watch on Saturday night. And I think it's going to be a big explosion.
Winky, you were one of your best performances. It's no stranger to us, is when you fought Felix Trinidad, a hard power puncher. For Keith Thurman, he's fighting a power puncher in Manny Pacquiao, a guy who's explosive, who has dynamite in both hands. When you fought Trinidad, you didn't get hit much, but when he hits you, how did you maintain your composure, much like Keith Thurman, because he's going to get hit by Manny Pacquiao on Saturday night, in terms of him maintaining his poise and remaining calm under pressure?
Well, like you said, everybody was worried about when Tito hit me, how I was going to handle it. Well, they should have been thinking when I hit him, how he was going to handle it. So, you know, it's just, you know, you got to go in with a game plan. My game plan against Trinidad was to keep him off balance, use the jab to not let him get set. And as you can see, whenever he's set, I hit him with a jab. So same thing with Manny. Like I'm telling Keith, if Manny in and out, if you don't let him get timing, every time he jump, you catch him with a jab, now you're keeping him off balance, then he can't get set to hit you hard. How you gonna hit somebody hard if you're all balanced? So Manny needs the in and out to become powerful. But if Keith can keep him all balanced with a good jab and make him respect his power, it's gonna be a long night for Manny.
Marco, with Keith Thurman, we have seen the fact that Thurman is susceptible to body shots. You know Manny Pacquiao quite well, obviously. Do you think Manny is going to focus and have an emphasis on targeting the body of Keith Thurman on Saturday?
Bueno, lo que pasa es que el estilo de Manny Pacquiao es pegar al cuerpo todo el tiempo. Lo vuelvo a repetir, en la primera pelea a mí me desinfló al cuerpo más que pegarme arriba. Y es un golpe que tiene muy bien hecho, un cruzado de mano izquierda, te lo clava impresionante en la boca del estómago. Entiendo que va a ser el camino que siempre ha tomado Manny Pacquiao, y más ahora que va con un joven 10 años menos. Tiene que minar su condición física.
Well, that's Manny's style. Manny hits to the body. When he hits that left right into the stomach, it's devastating. That's how he hit me in that first fight that we've had. So, and now fighting a younger guy, 10 years younger than him, he's really going to work the body on Saturday.
Well, now we're going to open it up to the media here. If you have any questions for our legend, Sean Porter, Winky Wright, Marco Antonio Barrera, Eric Morales. If you have questions, by all means, flag down Sam from Swanson Communications, and they will get you a microphone.
Quinky, trainer, Dan Burningham being the trainer, what sort of, how good is he at putting together a game plan, and what do you think he's done in terms of seeing things in Manny that can be attacked?
Well, you know, he's been around the game for a long time. He understands style, make fights. You know, Manny is just a tough fighter to really say one thing that you can do against him to make it work. So we know that, you know, you got to keep him off balance. We know that you got to be able to work a lot because Manny, his output is very high. But at the same time, we know that he's successful. He's easily get hit by big punches. So if we go in there and work hard and hit him just as hard as he's trying to hit us, something going to give. Like I said, Manny's 40 now. Manny ain't 35, 30. You know, so far the time is undefeated. We'll see.
Hey, guys, I just got a question for our three Hall of Famers upstage. And I know Sean's the WBC champion, but Morales, you beat Pacquiao here, 2005. Winky, you beat Trinidad here, 2005. And Marco, you beat Hamed here, 2001. Who had the best performance out of the three of you? Which fight was the greatest performance?
Winky Wright.
Them fighters. Listen, man, I always enjoy watching these guys fight, man. He always gave tough fights. I mean, come the will, the determination to get in there and dig and be a tough fighter, that's my man. So, like I said, these two fighters, great Mexican fighters, and I'm glad to be here with them.
Okay. All right, so obviously all the fighters on the panel here are technicians in their own right, their own style and everything. And I just want to pose to Sean first and then the rest. How do you feel that, you know, with Manny Pacquiao's, you know, awkward style and awkward rhythm, how would Keith Thurman be able to nullify that, you know, with such an awkward rhythm and style to pick up on?
You know what, from being in camp with Manny and watching him work with Freddie, I know that they work a lot on angles. They work on throwing the punches on different angles. And, you know, when you're a southpaw, you usually are in the ring with orthodox fighters. So for him to punch on those angles is something that the repetition is like, it's unmatched for him. On the other side of it, I know that Keith is a very smart guy. I know that Dan Birmingham, he's smart as well. The gentleman back there asked about game planning. They've gotten together. They've watched film. They've watched the way Manny throws his punches. They watched him take his steps. They watched, you know, the angles at which he throws. So I'm sure they figured out how to defend and how to step as Manny steps. And I think that this is a really good fight for both guys because Keith is young enough. He's smart enough. He's quick enough and fast enough to make those steps when Manny makes those steps. You know, I'm sure that they've studied it and they've seen it. It's all about timing. And on the other side of it, you have Manny, who's been doing this for so long. For him, he can almost close his eyes and throw the punches without even seeing that guy because he's done it so many times. He knows where that guy should be, you know. So I just think that it's going to be a really fun fight. And, you know, you're really going to see game plans from the opening bell. And you'll see him break down, and you'll be able to see it through the course of the fight.
Half jokingly, Eric Morales said not in this lifetime, but he was joking around. He said it's going to be a great fight between Pacquiao and Thurman.
And then another quick question. Obviously, with Manny Pacquiao being a southpaw, Winky, have you, and both to Eric Morales and Marco Antonio Barrera, have you seen earlier in his career where a lot of people felt he was just, you know, 1-2 left hand dominant fighter? He's become a little bit more educated with the jab and with his lead hand. Do you feel that may play a factor in the fight coming up?
Bueno, yo creo que más que aprender a boxear ese 1-2, como lo dice, se volvió un poco no yendo tanto para enfrente, no buscando el knockout desde ese golpe que recibió contra Juan Manuel Márquez. No ha sido el mismo buscando el combate cara a cara, sino ya más precavido. Empieza con la mano derecha de jab, cruza con la izquierda, se mueve más con pasos laterales, pero tiene Manny Pacquiao como 9-10 años que no se encuentra con el knockout como era antes.
No, at the beginning, of course, with that 1-2, he was devastating and he was always looking for the knockout, but he's learned. Now, he, like you said, he's using more the jab. Since that Juan Manuel Marquez that knocked him out, he basically has been not, you know, moving a lot and not looking for the knockout early.
All right, right here, guys. This is a two-part question, and anybody on the panel can answer this. One, how much do you guys think the ring rust will be on Keith Thurman? He's been pretty inactive the last 4 years. He didn't look real good against Josecito Lopez. Not to take anything away from Lopez, but he's no Manny Pacquiao. Do fighters also, do they kind of overlook sometimes a fighter that isn't such a big name like Pacquiao? Do you think maybe Thurman would have just overlooking Josecito Lopez when he fought him, and maybe that's why he didn't look that good? Or was it the ring rust, or a combination of both?
I think it was a combination of both. I think that, you know, Keith at that time, you know, before he got injured and had to take the time off, he thinking about big fights. He was thinking about a Manny Pacquiao fight. He thinking about another Sean Porter or, you know, one of the other guys. So it was him not really focusing on so much about Lopez, but thinking about beyond Lopez. And, yeah, the ring rust, you know, it's hard to fight once every year, you know what I'm saying, and come out and be sharp. But like I said, I think he looked good. You know, Lopez is a tough fighter. You saw that dude come out, and he took a lot of shots. A lot of people couldn't take them punches Keith was hitting them with. But he took them, and he gave them back. And Keith took his and gave them back. So them the things that make a young fighter grow to become a great fighter. So a lot of these young fighters get these fights that they should be. Nope, they're not tested. You know, keeping the fights where he's been tested, he's been hurt, he overcome it. So that's what make you great, when you can overcome something and come out victorious.
Bueno, el boxeo es un tema de estilos. El estilo de Josecito, de Thurman, es algo que se le prestó, y sobre todo que Thurman venía del de dos años, un año pasadito de descanso. El boxeo que empleó para la pelea y el estilo que tiene se le presta mucho a Josecito. El estilo de Thurman es un estilo que se le presta a Pacquiao en su totalidad. Además que tiene mayor experiencia, sabe con mayor los tiempos. Hoy mismo, de lo que hablaban ahorita, de la experiencia que tiene o de la precaución que pone para cada pelea, es diferente. Pero al final del día, es un peleador que sabe llevar a sus rivales, sabe meter la presión, pega fuerte, tiene velocidad. De alguna u otra forma, los ataques que le vienen los evade con una facilidad porque es zurdo, camina bien. Entonces, en realidad, es una pelea muy complicada para Thurman.
Boxing is a fight of styles. So the Josecito Lopez fight against Keith Thurman, it suited him well. But against Manny Pacquiao, the fight really suits Pacquiao in regards to the way he moves, the way he can pressure. So it's going to be a great fight. But Thurman, I think his style is more suited for... So Pacquiao's will overcome everything that maybe Thurman could bring, because his style fits Manny Pacquiao's style.
Question over here, Egypt from 100 Deep. So for my guys, Sean and Winky, I want to know, there was a video game called Fight Night. I want to know what the rating you would give for Pacquiao and for Thurman. And I also want to know from Mr. Morales and Mr. Barrera how they felt also about being included in the game, and if we need to have one now.
Was it 200 for the game? Yeah. 200, right? Manny, I would say right now, 91. And Manny Pacquiao, or excuse me, Keith Thurman, I would say 88 for Keith. Yeah, I would say 88 for Keith.
I'll flip it the other way. Flip vice versa.
Can you repeat the question there?
Video game. What they would give the ratings to Pacquiao and Thurman. You want to look at the
actualmente, como está el boxeo, pues yo creo que es más alto, ¿no? Porque es lo que, la pelea del sábado, lo que queremos ver, las ganas que tiene Thurman de quedarse con toda la historia de Manny Pacquiao.
No, in regards to the ratings, because of the fight that we're going to see on Saturday, I both give them high ratings for this.
My question is for everyone on the panel. Your thoughts on the loss of the great Pernell Whitaker?
My thoughts on that. Boxing loss, a great ambassador, a great fighter. Pernell Whitaker's skills were tremendous. His ability to stand right in front of you, make you miss, and look smooth and look pretty while he did it was incredible. He was an 84 gold medalist, a great fighter. You know, he beat a young De La Hoya went in his prime, but he got a draw. So Pete was a great fighter, man. You know, it was a tragedy for him to pass in that manner. And like I said, we want to send condolences out to him and his family.
For Sean and Winky in the back left over here, guys, I just want to ask about the distance and the impact of distance. Keith is going to have a pretty significant reach advantage. How does each guy have to get to the correct distance for themselves? What do they have to do to be able to get to the distance they need to be effective?
Well, if you pay attention to Manny, you know, his rhythm is how he gets to anybody. And his rhythm is somewhat of an in-out, in-in-in-out, in-out. And then he mixes it up so that his opponent can't really catch on to that rhythm and get the timing. I think that's definitely going to be an attribute for him in terms of trying to get close to Keith and punch Keith. And then Keith, on the other hand, I think Keith is just going to have to remain calm, remain poised, and find him with his jab. Find him with his jab, and then use his feet. You know, Keith is funny, man. It's when I watch Keith in my mind. Just seeing the way he moves around the ring, you know, to the average eye, it's like it's not really doing much, but it's enough for him. Yep. The way he moves, he creates distance that, you know, when you're on the other side of it, you may think you have it and then you lose it. You think you got it and you lose it, you know. So it's definitely going to be a game of feet, and it's definitely going to be a game of chess in this fight.
Now it is that time for us to go around the panel as we get set for Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman this Saturday live on pay-per-view. We'll start off with Eric Morales first of all, and we go ahead and we want prediction time. Eric, how is the fight going to play out?
Bueno, va a ser una pelea complicada el inicio de la pelea, en lo que se acomodan, pero a partir del segundo o tercer round Pacquiao debe despegar y debe mantener un ritmo de trabajo alto donde lo mantenga ocupado, y yo creo que pudiera noquearlo a final de la pelea o ganar la decisión. Pacquiao.
It's going to be a complicated fight, no doubt about it, but knowing Pacquiao, starting in the second round, that's when he's going to be starting to charge, so it's either going to be decision Pacquiao or maybe late a knockout by Pacquiao.
Marco, your prediction.
Bueno, yo creo que Manny Pacquiao por decisión, pero sin descartar las ganas y el plan de pelea que trae Thurman.
I think Manny Pacquiao by decision, but you always have to take into account the plan that Thurman has. It could play a part, but Manny Pacquiao decision.
Winky?
You know, everybody know I'm going for Keith Thurman. I think Thurman by knockout or Thurman by decision, I think that, you know, he's going to come out. He's going to make Manny respect his speed and his power. Like Sean said, it's all about distance, about dictating enough room for Thurman to get off and Pacquiao not to get off. Pacquiao used to fighting bigger fighters with long reach, and his in and out movement get him there. But, you know, Keith got great foot movement, and like I said, he punched hard with both hands. So I like Thurman all the way.
And now the WBC welterweight champion of the world, Showtime Sean Porter. How is he going to unfold on Saturday night?
There's a funny thing about that word prediction. I hate it. This fight could, this is my disclaimer. This fight could play out so many different ways. I mean, and to simplify it, I personally see 3 or 4 different ways that this fight could play out. I know what Keith is going to do. Keith is going to try to come out early. He's going to try to get Manny. If he doesn't touch Manny the way he wants to touch him early on, he's going to lay back. He's going to try to box. He's going to try to box his way to a victory. I think the problem with that is Manny has a high work rate. Manny knows what he wants to see, and he takes it when he sees it. I think if Keith does not get him early, Manny wins a late decision.
Well, thank you guys very much. Give a round of applause to our legends. Showtime, Sean Porter, Winky Wright, Marco Antonio Barrera, Eric Morales. Thank you so much to the media for coming out and partaking in this roundtable. We look forward to seeing you later this afternoon.